Hey, welcome!
Wir sind das junge Bauhaus.
Willkommen in unserem Podcast, Bauhaus Puls.
We're a group of students who are really into art, just trying to investigate the Bauhaus together and kind of shed a bit more light on what Bauhaus really was, what it is today. After experimenting with a few mediums to document our journey, we found a podcast, and we thought that this was an ideal way to share our investigation with you and maybe reach some people that would like to learn more about the Bauhaus.
Wir sind Patty,
Lilly,
Okan,
Mama,
Mia,
Kaya,
Nora,
Bruno,
Petrota.
We're sitting on the floor in the library, in the back of the Schiller Theater, and
it smells like books.
Everything.
Yeah, hier ist die Akustik wohl am besten.
Subscribe and like this podcast. Maybe we'll get a studio next time.
Seriously.
We realized we've been working with Bauhaus a lot, but we've still struggled to come up with a definition. In this episode, we started off by going on the street and seeing what people thought about when they heard the word Bauhaus.
What is the first word that comes to mind when you hear the word Bauhaus?
Das erste Gedanke. Na, Dessau? Auf jeden Fall.
Reduzierte Form. Also die Form an sich vom Bauhaus, die Architektur. So ein paar Bilder im Kopf, genau.
Ich glaube, ich denke am meisten an Architektur und an klare Form und Farben.
Nichts? Nee, nicht wirklich, nicht viel, nee.
Bauhaus, wo man einkaufen kann, Bauhaus.
Der Baumarkt.
Der Baumarkt.
Ja, dass man da Sachen zum Baum kaufen kann. Irgendwie eleganten Minimalismus.
Bauhaus.
Haus?
Nee, ja, Bauhaus, Baufinanzierung, würde ich sagen, ja, genau, ja.
Weimar, ja, Funktionalität, vielleicht ein Unterschied zu der Bauweise während des Kaiserreichs, wobei ich die eigentlich präferiere, weil die viel aufwendiger ist und auch schöner, ja, aber Funktionalität.
Kunst, ich verbinde mit, wenn ich Bauhaus höre, Kunst.
Ein Einrichtungsstil, der eigentlich schon ein bisschen älter ist, aber wie ich finde, nach und nach wieder mehr in Mode kommt und wo Leute mehr und mehr drüber reden, so ein bisschen. Das ist ja
Bauhaus.
So, what do you mean? This Bauhaus?
Yeah.
This is a museum, I think.
A what?
A museum.
Bauhaus is kind of building style, and it's very practical, I suppose.
Is very practical.
And Bauhaus for building something inside.
Yeah. Minimalism, steel constructions, Walter Gropius. Then, do you know this universal Bauhaus connector? Like, I actually have a book with me about it.
Bauhaus, diese stylische Kunst, so kleine Haushaltsartikel, die alten schönen Architekturen, die gab es auch mal, ne, vor 50 Jahren oder so, ein Haus bauen, yeah. Joint bauen.
the market.
For me, I feel like it's like a building supermarket where you get all kind of spare parts and everything.
Strict, simple, but aesthetic and not totally harmonious, because I like it especially.
It's a difficult question. Architecture and artist group exactly 100 years ago.
Bauhaus, an einem Bauernhof.
Design.
Clarity of purpose. Freedom, experiment, return to basics.
So ein bisschen so ein neuer Wind in einer damals relativ konservativen Zeit, würde ich sagen.
So, as you could just hear by the results, some people had a lot of knowledge and brought in a lot of background information that perhaps we wouldn't even have come up with, and others could perhaps listen to this podcast to gather a better idea of what the Bauhaus even is. So after leaving the streets of Berlin and asking the public what they thought of Bauhaus, we decided to get an expert opinion.
Deswegen sind wir ins Bauhaus-Archiv gegangen und haben Esther Kleve gefragt.
Ich bin ausgebildete Kunsthistorikerin, aber mit der Kunst allein habe ich mich schon lange nicht mehr beschäftigt, sondern eigentlich mit Kunst und Kultur, Produktion im 20. Jahrhundert. Das ist so mein Thema. Und also aus meiner Perspektive habe ich natürlich täglich zu tun mit Bauhaus und dem, was Menschen über Bauhaus denken, wissen oder wissen wollen oder nicht wissen. Und das Erste, was man dann aus der Perspektive denkt, ist, dass es unglaublich schwer ist zu definieren, was Bauhaus ist. Was aber auch schon wieder sehr interessant ist, wenn man darüber berichtet oder erzählt. Also ein sehr komplexes Thema, eine Herausforderung für Historiker und Museumsleute, um das auseinander zu dividieren und vermittelbar zu machen. Eine wahnsinnig kreative Schule letztendlich dann doch in einer ganz wichtigen Zeit für unsere Kulturgeschichte, aber auch ein Verwirrspiel, ein Spiegelpalast, die unschuldige Utopie.
So that was really interesting what Esther said, especially that with like the unschuldige Utopie. Do we like discuss that? I think that was quite interesting.
Mm-hmm. The innocent utopia.
Yeah.
What do you think?
I mean, it's difficult. On one hand, the designs were amazing, and there's no doubt about that. But in the general,
I guess you could say. I mean, what do they mean by innocent? Definitely, the Bauhaus had amazing designs, but. What about the sexism, or maybe the lack of opportunities for women? Can we talk about that real
definitely.
Quick?
Mm-hmm.
It's true that women were only allowed to like kind of do the textile workshops.
Yeah. I mean, if we want to talk about women in the Bauhaus who really made it, I mean, one example I think that everybody knows is Marianne Brandt, who was actually told by Moholy Nagy to become the leader of the metal workshop in 1928. And I mean, for the time and for the movement, that was actually quite a stride.
Yeah, then sie hat dann denke ich auch gut als Vorbildfunktion für andere Frauen im Bauhaus agiert.
Aber insbesondere weil Metall ja auch eher als männlich gilt.
It's often very problematic putting a label such as innocent utopia on something that's so multifaceted, because there's always going to be an issue with something and nobody's perfect.
So. There's always room for improvement.
Yeah, it's true. But I think definitely the Spiegelpalast thing that you said, I definitely agree with that.
Yeah.
I think that was a beautiful metaphor that she said,
Yeah, I mean, I feel like there's a lot to talk about with Bauhaus. There were so many different sections. And personally, even though I feel like I do know a lot about Bauhaus, I think there's so much more to discover about the school and the movement and the people that were part of it and all of the different aspects of it, because some people would say Bauhaus was a school, some people would say it was a movement, and I guess it was both, but I think Bauhaus is multifaceted and very interesting.
We all here kind of have a general knowledge about the Bauhaus Archive. Personally, I think a lot about the costumes that they made and about shapes, not only squares and triangles, but like
organic
shapes.
Yeah.
And just a lot of experimentation and a whole new design at the time. So it was a big step from like Art Nouveau and all the prior. Mm-hmm.
It's quite hard putting you on the spot when you just have like a simple answer.
If I say, like, if I think about Bauhaus, I would just say it's a combination of aesthetic and like
functionality.
Thank you. Exactly, because I don't know, like when you look at a lot of their things, it's not only like visually pleasing, it is also practical, and that's also ties into the whole like aspect of like minimalism a little bit, because like with their shapes, they are very like, I don't know, or basic in like their most like raw form, if you will.
Yeah.
You know, so like I think it's boiled down to the essential of like what is necessary to make it visually pleasing, but also functionally like.
Mm-hmm. Like it wasn't something that you see in a museum.
It was
that's
really
like
accessible. So like as an art movement, it was kind of unique, I guess.
Yeah.
Because I mean, it's strange to talk about Bauhaus a bit because we feel like we know, like Nora said, you feel like you kind of know about Bauhaus, but at the same time, you're like, well, you know, it's like, well,
so many aspects, you know?
So much
because
to know.
Because obviously the photography is going to be, like, different from, like, I don't know, the household products or whatever, like an ashtray, you know? There's, like, sure they have some things in common, but, like,
it, like, really weaseled its way into, like, every single part of, like,
of art. Yeah,
yeah, like, literally. Like, photography.
And for something that was, like, for something that was so groundbreaking at the time, like, if you think about like the styles before that were really like Art Nouveau or something. That was like really so much like decoration, and the purpose was that everything looks good. And even if it's like an I don't know, like an egg cup or something. Yeah, like it still had to look a certain way.
So decadent
way.
And like so like over the top.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like,
and then comes Bauhaus and they're just like, here's a square teapot. And you're like, oh, yeah.
But on one hand you have that, and on the other hand you have stuff like Kandinsky, which I find, I don't really think about if I think about Bauhaus, but he was also part of Bauhaus and part of the movement. And I think that there's so much to it that, like you said, you wouldn't really see photography as something functional, but it's still Bauhaus and it's still part of the school and what was taught there. Also with the Vorkursübungen, like you wouldn't think that functionality would have anything to do with just taking a piece of chalk and drawing your heartbeat on a piece of paper, but that's also part of Bauhaus, and I think...
That also ties into the fact of like freedom and like being able to express yourself in many different types of aspects, you know, like not being like shut into like a little box and like you have to do that. And, like.
Well, what we're going to do is we're going to do a quick round of just shooting out words that come to mind when we think of Bauhaus.
Until one of us runs out, until we run out of words.
Okay, I like
to say.
Yay. Who starts?
You start.
Okay. Shape.
Fluidity.
Color.
Alltag.
Functionality.
Geometrische Form.
Rot.
Quadrat.
Farbkonzepte. Teapot.
Komplementärfarben.
Primary colors.
Sleek.
Architecture.
Elegant.
Functional.
Minimalistisch.
Efficient.
Aesthetic.
Raw.
Modern.
Textiles.
Innovation.
Different materials.
Industrie.
Praktisch.
Gropius.
Design.
Free. Architektur.
Baugestaltung.
Josef Beuys.
Kultur.
Geschichte.
Fortschrittlich.
Johannes Itten.
Lux Feininger.
Marianne Brandt.
Bauhaussiedlung.
Weimar. I think of Chicago.
Because you know, after the Bauhaus school was closed, like many like Bauhaus students and like professors, they like flee to America and they opened up the Bauhaus in Chicago, which is called, I think, New Bauhaus.
Okay, yeah. That's really interesting.
They carried out the Bauhaus style like all over the world.
All over
internationally.
Every person, or so many people at least, could relate to it. And it was
like Tel Aviv is like the most Bauhaus city in the world.
Tel Aviv?
Like, they have the most Bauhaus architecture.
Wow. Yeah.
See how international Bauhaus, man.
I think of glass as well.
Glass?
Glass. There are so many different... See, people always think of, like,
it's
architecture,
insane.
But, like, how much was there in Bauhaus? There was, like, you could do anything from knitting to photography to theater. Because you were just saying that, like, that Bauhaus is really was really accessible and still is really accessible.
Yeah.
I mean, if I think about the Marcel Breuer-Stuhl, I don't know if this is bad or not, but I think of a doctor's office because of those like
it's
sleek
so
chairs.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
Yeah.
They have those sleek chairs, and that's internationally that's a
true.
Thing. That
it
kind of chair.
So the next question is, what would we like to know more about the Bauhaus?
I would really love to know more about the theater they did.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you kind of hear a bit about the ballet and all that,
true.
But there's not that much you can actually find about the Bauhaus theater. And
it would be cool if like. They would kind of do like a Bauhaus theater, like
redemption.
Redemption,
not redemption, but like
no, you know what
a
I mean.
Revival,
a
Bauhaus theater,
you know I mean?
Revival. I'll
imagine
be there
that.
For that
with
absolutely.
The costumes and everything. I feel like that would be so cool because oh my god, yeah,
absolutely, yeah, that'd be amazing. And also for me, another aspect I would love to learn more about is the woman in Bauhaus and how it was for them, like. Studying there, working there.
And
but
also
I think
the quality a little bit because, you know, like you said, Marianne Brandt and the steelworks and like how they were implemented also in the men's roles, you know, how they were also like they had a part in it.
I maybe would like to find out more about their everyday life when they were in school.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, then I would say maybe find out how was their life there and.
So today we set out to find a definition for Bauhaus, but what did we actually find?
There is no definition.
There's too many.
It's a Spiegelpalast.
Yeah.
Ja, ich glaube, aus jeder Perspektive kann man das anders sehen.
Nächstes Mal haben wir ein neues Thema, was sich auch mit dem Bauhaus befasst.
Yeah, thank you for joining us for this episode.
Thanks for listening.
Yeah.
Ja, wir freuen uns auf das nächste Mal.
We've got some exciting episodes coming up, so stay tuned.
Thank you.
Mhm.